Welcome back, my naughty little donkey. Some cow. My next guest comedy is available from his website, hippieman.com. Please welcome the very funny John Novosad, everybody.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. You know, a lot of people ask me if I'm a real hippie, and I was. I was raised by hippies. My mom sent me to school every day with the Jimi Hendrix lunchbox, and all the kids made fun of me till they tried one of my brownies. Let's just say I could pretty much trade my lunch for anything after that. And I do. I travel all over the country. You know, I have a lot of time to kill during the day, so I like to make my own fun. Like, I'll go to job interviews I'm not qualified for, just looking like this, you know? Yeah. Kills a little time, you know? And they always ask the same questions over and over again, like, how many words can you type a minute? I'm like, well, it depends on the word. Yeah. I can type the crap out of A, I'll tell you that. Boy, I've never counted, but I think I'm the record holder. So, here's something else I like to do for fun. I will run out of a barber shop and go, don't go in there. I'll tell you, there is nothing worse than a pissed off barber. They don't give a damn. They'll run with scissors. I did a show a couple nights ago. Some lady asked if my hair was natural. I'm like, where the hell would you go to get your hair done like this? It's not like I walk into a salon and go, hey, I want to look like Yanni on a bender. Can you make that happen for me? Wow, I cracked myself up on that one because I'm a hippie and I forget this stuff and then I hear it again. And I am. I'm easily confused, you know. I get up in the morning, see my reflection in the mirror. I'm like, wow, that is one ugly-looking chick right there, I'll tell you that. I am never drinking tequila again. So, you know, I travel over the country, and man, here's the thing that I've decided is true. Politicians don't care about us. Republicans or Democrats, state, local, or feds, they don't care. I decided it was up to me to come up with a plan for America, and I did. And I call it Hippie Man's Plan for America, because after all, I am Hippie Man as well. And, you know, it also includes my recipe for brownies, which is a big part of the plan. Yeah. Yeah, all right. I don't like to brag, but two of those brownies would have wrapped up that whole Iraqi thing in like 2 days, man. That guy would have come out of the desert and said, hey, I'll tell you where the WMD is. Just give me a bottle of water. I have got some ass-kicking cotton mouth. And, you know, let's... All right, thank you. Wow, you guys are coming on board with the plan. That's good. For a minute, I thought we had a room full of Republicans, and that was freaking me out. But actually, I am. I'm a registered Republican, because I just like showing up to the conventions and freaking them out. I'm like, hey, how you doing? They're like, hey, you're not a Republican. I'm like, yeah, I am. When I tie my hair back, I look like that guy on the nickel. But let's talk about, you know, the issues like immigration. President Bush talked about immigration, and here's my plan for immigration. I would take all the illegal immigrants, make them U.S. citizens, give them higher paying jobs, and then outsource their jobs to India and go, welcome to America, pal. And let's talk about health insurance, you know? Health insurance is another issue. A lot of people don't have health insurance. I'm a nightclub entertainer. I don't have health insurance. I mean, I do sort of at the grocery store. I can go and get my blood pressure checked. That's pretty much my benefit package. But it's a PPO, so I can go to any grocery store across the country, yeah. And I did. I found a doctor who works at my local grocery store, and he works in the deli, so it's kind of one-stop shopping, you know? Like, hey, I'd like a pound of provolone and a prostate check if you don't mind. Yeah, I learned to always order the cheese first on that transaction, I can tell you that. Oh, man. And you might notice by looking at me that I do. I have a weird-ass wandering eye way off to the right here, man. It's Well, thanks for laughing. Wait till you hear about the hernia. But I do. I have a weird-ass wandering eye. I can be looking this way and I see people over there. They're not dead people, but I see them. And finally, tonight, I wanted to talk about the draft. You know, in Hippie Man's Plan for America, I would reinstitute the draft. And it's not what you think. I would draft hardened criminals and send them over to Afghanistan looking for Osama bin Laden, you know? And here's the deal. If you catch him, you get out of jail free. If not, you're wandering around Afghanistan. What the hell do I care? So, thank you so much, you guys. Have a good night.